At Emory, we perform over 150 robotic bypass procedures per year. What this means is that not only our surgeons, but the entire team, meaning in the operating room, in the intensive care unit, and on the telemetry floor afterwards, is extremely comfortable caring for and helping patients recover from this procedure.
Typically, when we do a traditional bypass operation, or traditional CABG, the chest is open, the patient's put on the heart-lung machine, we stop the heart to sew the arteries or veins to the heart, and then we let the heart start beating and we come off the heart-lung machine. It's a major operation. In a robotic-assisted bypass surgery, there's no division of any bones. So the prolonged recovery associated with allowing the sternum or any bones to heal is no longer an issue.
Some of the benefits of robotic coronary bypass surgery are that we don't need to use the heart-lung machine and we don't need to stop your heart. There's less bleeding and less infection and a much faster return to normal activities. Patients tell me that they're thankful that soon after surgery they're able to lift up and play with their children and they can return to hobbies like golf and tennis much sooner than if they'd had a traditional bypass operation.
So avoiding the heart-lung machine, not stopping the heart, not dividing any bones, no rib spreading. There's several advantages to this. It can ensure a faster recovery. It's still major surgery. It's still associated with postoperative pain. But the rate of recovery, what we've experienced and what we've seen with our patients, is at least 2 to 3 times faster than a traditional open chest procedure. We've seen less bleeding, lower blood transfusions, less atrial fibrillation, less problems with wound healing, and most patients are able to get back to a normal lifestyle with great long-term results. And all of this we've studied very carefully to make sure we're doing the right thing for all of these patients.
Typically, surgery lasts anywhere from 3 to 4 hours. You're obviously all the way to sleep for this procedure under general anesthesia. After surgery, you'll go to the intensive care unit for typically just one night, and you'll be in the hospital usually about 3 days. At the time of discharge, you should be able to get yourself dressed, make yourself breakfast, do some things around the home. You'll be tired and sore for a couple of weeks after surgery, but there are no major activity restrictions. As soon as you're not taking the narcotic pain medicines, you're able to drive, and you should be able to return to most of your normal activities within 4 weeks after surgery.
With an annual volume of approximately 150 robotic-assisted CABG procedures annually, that would make us one of the top robotic-assisted coronary bypass surgery programs in the country.